ha ha ha, I dropped the camera, I'm leaving it in just like it was. I'm gonna transfer it that way. I just had it in my mouth because with no tripod with me out here right now, hold it in my hand, my can in one hand and this in the other hand, I had to put it in my mouth and it fell right out. Maybe my mouth's not so big, huh? Gunshots over in the down the river down there. Anyway, this pepper's gonna be raised, not raised so much, but about 6 inches or so. We're gonna take those cinder blocks. The pepper garden will be a little bit smaller as far as lengthwise, and maybe not as deep from here toward the house. Not by much, but we're gonna do a little border with those cinder blocks and put topsoil, potting soil on top. So, well, again, thanks to Mr. Bennett up on that, and go up around the curb up there, and his house is up there. His house was torn down. It was an old house. He's in another house he's renting. Right across, it's on the same property, basically. And the garden out here, I'm tearing it down. I'm cutting down all the seeds from the torch sunflowers. You see how they're still putting out here? It's Sunday the 20th of September, I believe. Not 20th, 20th of September. I took up that one tomatillo that was just, the leaves were all off it. I don't know, insects, what the problem. Here's one we put out from inside the house. It was small. I have nothing to compare it to, but it was lower than that first ring on that, basket. And look how it's come up. But without butterflies, we got butterflies still with these torches. That's why I'm letting this go, if it'll pollinate it any at all. I don't know if it will. It's so late. But so you see butterflies still out here. In the summer, butterflies like crazy, bees like crazy. Even had some of our hummers come over here. And they come over here once in a while too, but like I say, all the flowers are near the bottom there. You see that butterfly, he's coming back down there. Where's he at? There he is. There's another one like it over there. Somewhere, I can't see with this cracked viewfinder, so hopefully you're seeing him right there, I think. Yeah, that's him. I'm trying to take care not to kill the flowers off, because they'll be dying off here in another couple weeks or so. Some of them you see in there, they're dying off, and you got a little bit of you see the orange petals still and the yellow nectar. But these are the ones that these butterflies are going to still. That's what helped the flowers over here with the purple potted beans. These are the Jackson Wonder bean, which is like a lima bean we found out, purple. Color and whatnot. See, that's why I was tearing those down carefully, not to hurt the regular flowers. All that's got to come down. That okra is going to come up here next year. It's going to be in this first garden here. About three rows of four. So it'll be 12 at least, maybe a little bit more. I don't know. The tomatoes, I don't know. We're going to put the tomatoes back where the okra is. Have three rows of five or six. If that should come out a lot better too, because that gets a lot of sun in the morning. But they gotta come up in the house first. This one here has been decimated because of the hornworm and a little bit of brown spot that was come up, and then I just start cutting branches off like the idiot that I am about gardening. And now you see the condition it is. There's a three tomatoes on here. And might still get green tomatoes, might get red tomatoes here, I don't know. That one there too, hornworm and the brown spot got all over this. And I was being the idiot again, like I say, breaking off branches left and right, trying to starve it back or whatever, but the results are the same. There are tomatoes on there, there's a small one on there. I don't know if I can get on that, I don't know if you find with the crack, but right there, I can see it at the bottom. That little tomato right there. Okay, I don't know if that's the same one. Right there, where do I see my, I'm gonna find my, okay, right there. I can't see with this viewfinder crack, but anyway, it's a small, tiny one. But there's a bunch of on here. Bell pepper over here, pimento, I've got about four or five of these. Don't see, that's the thing, I loved pimento when I was a kid with pimento and cheese. But I don't know what else you can do with pimento. I've got three in the house, and you see these here. Again, I can't see with this damn viewfinder. They make this purposely like this, so you can't really see on this viewfinder, especially on a sunny day. And plus now I have a big crack across it. But, you know, I got 3, 4, 5 pimentos on 6, a small one down that way. Again, I can't see. Right there's a small one. There's one there and a small one on the other side. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on here. 7 with that little tiny one. Kale, we have no idea what to do with it. Joke. Oh, these are coming back. Put these out here. I thought they were dying off, but look, they come back. I watered them about 5 days ago. Tore up those purple hull peas. There's 4 that I just dropped the seeds and they started growing. Didn't realize it, didn't do it on purpose. I just had dropped them when I was pulling them out before, because these were so crowded they were diseased, because they were just on top of you. I had like 4 in each one. Didn't mean that. I might have put 2 or 3, but I was putting 4 and 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 stations. And they choked off right here. Some of these are getting burned. Purple hull pea right here. Look at that one. Look how they're growing out pretty good. But to be late September, we'll see. There's flowers here, but again, butterflies and bees. I don't know if we have any more. The black-eyed peas are just about done. Don't know if this is from disease or what. That's another one. There's like 2 or 3 in one little space there. I picked some of the pods out that were okay. I actually had maggots, little tiny maggot-type worms in a couple pods, you know. More than a couple. Probably all total 7, 8 pods. Not at one time, different times. So again, next year this will be a whole lot better. We're going to spread it out better. The purple hull peas and the black-eyed peas will not be in the same location here. They'll be spread out more further west. I'm putting my sunflowers and stuff, I'm putting them on top of the garden like I did this year. I'm going to be out here. It's about 10 feet away from the garden all the way around. I got a giant U. So I'm going to have torch sunflowers and the big Titan and the smaller regular yellow sunflowers all mixed together all the way around. So it'll look like it did over there, but it'll be all around the garden here. It'll track flowers, it'll track butterflies and it'll track bees, and our hummers will be over here. And the yolk we're still putting out, I think next weekend, today's Sunday, next weekend we'll probably take these down. Today or tomorrow we're going to take down about 3 or 4 of these real big burgundy ones. I mean, they're still putting out a few, just like 1 or 2 pods or so, but we're going to use them as a natural barrier on our garden out front where my wife's got those knockout roses, which I found out is a genetically modified rose. But anyway, that one is about 12 feet tall. No, that's about 14 or 15 feet tall right there, actually. Look at the chemtrailer, the spray bastard up there in the sky. Excuse my mouth, but you know, hey, they want to kill us. Might as well point it out. Spray bastards don't take a day off. 7 days a week, 365 a year. Bastards. Back to the garden here and get these. See how they're all bare? The leaves are falling out here. We're going to use them in here for mulch. I'm going to pull the plastic back each time, half from where those sunflowers are to the middle here. Throw about half of these in here and till it into the soil. Pull this one back to about right there. Put some of this in there and over there. That's sunflowers. If I'm going to burn that over there or if I'm going to till it into the soil. I still got peanut plants in the back over there mixed in. They were in the base. I didn't know they would come out like they did either. I put them in with the edge of the oak right here, and you see how they've taken off, and there's a weed in there, I think, too. But see, I wouldn't want to be tearing this up because I don't know. But these are peanut plants. We have to pull the plastic back and dig down to get the peanuts out here probably about another month yet. End of October. The sunflowers, again, too close this year. Next year, they'll be out away from the garden more. All the way around, 3 sides this time. My junky built broken down tiller that I use. It ain't easy, especially with bad knees, man. But my wife and I are doing it. We'll get it out there this year, this fall. Probably in the next 2 to 3 weeks, I'll be out here. See, that's the thing. I gotta be careful with these okra here because I'm gonna probably end up having to tear it up. But I got these peanut plants here. It was like I put down 4 peanuts down there, 4 peanuts down there, and you see how they are. They said put down 2 to 4, and I thought, well, I'm gonna put 4 because I put 2 down last year and I ended up with really, really small, immature peanuts because we pulled them up too soon. But we'll have peanuts this year. One row. two rows of okra might pull up. I actually have to cut it. I get my jigsaw and cut the sucker, because, or a hacksaw, because, you know, I can't cut this. I don't have any tools to speak of, for that matter. Now that I think about it, I have to use a hacksaw to cut these trunks. And that's what they are. They're trunks. They're thick. And like I said, then we'll cut the branches down, use them for borders of the front porch with the knockout roses. These will be bordering all around. It'll look really, really nice next year. Unless, of course, they go for broke and we have all-out war in the country. So we'll see what happens. Your constitutional rights, or not necessarily rights, the inalienable rights of yours are given to your creator, whatever you believe. And if you don't believe in anything, it's a natural right as a human. So they can't take that away from you. Remember that. You have a right to defend yourself. And that does mean being armed if you have arms. And I don't mean the ones at your side, dummies. They know that. That's why they want to disarm you. They want to make it easy like sheep, because the majority of the people in this country are sheep. So, preach to you all year about growing something. We have quite a bit, especially okra, which is one of the best vegetables I found out if you look up nutrition-wise and healing and such. I mean, there's so many things, but this is long enough now. So, I've got a couple tomato plants over there that's got one or two small tomatoes that's going to end up getting pulled up, so I can till that all up. So, we'll have three rows of tomatoes back here. Okra will be right up here. And the beans and all that, we have to run from south to north. So I don't know if I'll do that in garden number two over there, and what the other half of garden number one will be. Garden three will be tomatoes, and after that, everything's up in the air right now. We've got a lot of stuff other than tomato, which I wish we would have more tomatoes. So we'll see what happens with those tomato plants right there. Those are from in the house, by the way, too. Those are heirlooms we grew. So Heirloom Solutions is a good site if you want to get seeds and get yourself something like this, man. That's, I got 15 feet right there. I got to come out here and cut some okra. Probably get about 40 pods off here today. And like I say, if it's not today, maybe, well, probably today, this one might come down as big as it is. It's still putting out two or three pods only, but that's going to go good for the garden. That'll get cut down. Maybe the one next to it, the burgundy okra, the spineless green okra in the first row and the last fourth row over here, putting out good sized pods. So eating them off the stalk is good too, really good for you. Fresh.